Hi everyone, good morning. Very excited to be here. My name is Bryce, I'm with Komatsu. Very privileged and honored to be able to share with you today everything we're doing in partnership with Palantir, what we have going in terms of dynamic pricing. Just want to share a little bit with you on what we do at Komatsu. Really, at Komatsu, we're an industry lead in terms of original equipment manufacturing for many different industries. Our customers are in mining, they're in construction, they're in forklift, forestry, industrial machines. So we make equipment and service equipment across a wide range of markets. We have a couple terms at Komatsu that I wanted to leave with you today. One of those terms, very much synonymous with, I would say, the boots on the ground theme of AIPCon, but that term is the Gemba. The Gemba is really, it means where the work actually happens. So truly what we try to do is understand the challenge at the Gemba, what is the true challenge on the ground, and how can we solve for those challenges. Another term that we use is Dantotsu. Dantotsu means unparalleled and unrivaled solutions. So everything we do from an innovation perspective and a transformation perspective, we try to keep Dantotsu top of mind. And a third one, just give you some context in terms of the size and the magnitude of specifically our mining equipment, which I'll be talking a bit more about today. We use the term that if it's not grown, it's mined. So everything that you look at, everything you use in your everyday life, it was either grown from the earth or it was mined out of the earth. So we make a lot of big, heavy equipment and very excited to share how we're looking at that equipment, how we're dynamically pricing parts for that equipment as well. So I wanted to talk a little bit about how we're currently doing our dynamic pricing or what we're trying to achieve in terms of an objective for transforming our dynamic pricing models. Really, our challenge is threefold here. We have pricing analysts, we have pricing team members that are receiving hundreds of emails per day. And those analysts and the pricing team has to sift through a lot of emails, understand these inquiries that are coming in. Could be an inquiry for a new price for a specific part, could be a new sales order that was created. And really the team is tasked with having to go through these emails and work back into the system. A lot of manual tasks involved, right? And just a lot of bottlenecks in the process with a lot of throughput that could be realized. So we wanted to understand that challenge a bit further. We also need to coordinate across global regions. Our mining business is very much global in nature, and so trying to do this collaboration across global regions creates a lot of challenges as well. We also have a critical mission to maintain machine uptime for our customers out in the field. In mining operations, if machines are down, the operations are down. So we need to make sure that we're doing everything that we can for our customers and fulfilling our overall promise and our purpose in creating value together with our customers, to make sure that their machines are staying up in the field as much as possible. So the solution we'll be talking about today really was predicated on being able to gather information from a lot of different sources, a lot of different structured information and unstructured information, to be able to provide the team members enough information that they can then synthesize and make quick decisions on. So really the solution that we're gonna go into here is predicated on four main capabilities. The first here is a shared model that global regions can collaborate on, understand exactly what their pricing strategies are, understand the nuances and the differences across their pricing strategies, depending on their regions, and be able to share that model collectively amongst one another. The second is really an alerting workflow. So all of these emails that are coming in, how can we transform that into more of an alerting workflow so that analysts and pricing team members can effectively do their job, focus more on decision making, and be able to sift through and increase the throughput on all the information that they're gathering on a daily basis. Third, we have scenario analysis. So scenario analysis, really being able to look at an individual part or a batch grouping of parts and be able to understand whatever we're decisioning on for those parts. How does that potentially impact our overall objectives? How does that potentially impact our customers? And how do we optimize that in the longer run? And then lastly, we have batch pricing. Batch pricing allows us to actually take action, either to update the specific price of a part or be able to notify somebody that may be in a different region to communicate with them through this alerting and actioning workflow, and then be able to push those updates back into our source systems. So with that, I wanted to show a demo here on our Pricing 360 tool. So really today, we have all of these alerts that are coming through. Pricing analysts are going through these alerts, and really where we're going towards next is how do we utilize AI agents to be able to process these alerts for us. So AI agents really would have the capability to look at all these alerts for simple logic, simple rules that we could define as analysts and as team members, have the agent actually process through these alerts, but then identify ones that would require us to further investigate. So in this case, I do have an example part that I need to go and investigate. I can see that this particular part has an outlier price as compared to similar parts that, in terms of description, and it's also missing segment codes. So we'll take a look at this particular part and see what we might need to investigate. So going into the material details screen here, I can go ahead and look at all the information I would need on this specific part, including the price, the gross margin, the validity of the part, also the division that this part is associated with. I see that one particular issue is with this part. It's exceeding a maximum threshold. And this is based off of the suggested price that my now AI pricing advisor is making to me. The problem here is we don't want to necessarily outprice ourselves from the market, and we want to keep our customers satisfied, not increase the pricing margin by too much. So in this example, we'll look at how we can take the suggested price, the context on how our AI agent is providing this price, and understand what we might need to do to have a more proactive pricing recommendation made to us. So here I'm going to instruct my agent to go ahead and regenerate a new price suggestion. And this is going to trigger a chain of thought logic that I can go and look at all of the context and information that the AI agent is actually processing to make a better recommendation based on my feedback to the agent itself. So I can go ahead and look at all of the information that the agent is gathering and processing. It's utilizing tools like querying the ontology. It's also utilizing tools like calculator tool to be able to formulate a better recommendation for me, given the context I've provided it that it's exceeding our threshold for maximum price increases. So as I'm going through all of the information that the AI agent is processing, all the feedback that I've already given it and feedback I will continue to give it will be maintained and utilized by the model going forward so that it continuously trains and we can have continuous improvement as well. So with that, I'll be able to look at everything that the agent is going through. It's going to produce a new suggested price that I can evaluate. And I'm going to look at that new suggested price, all the considerations that it took, and be able to determine, do I want to keep this new suggested price, or do we need to think of another price to come up with? So looking at the results here, I can see that the AI agent has now taken into account everything that I've instructed it. It's now within the threshold for maximum price increase, and I would like to accept this, this suggestion. So going back to our material details screen, I can get the context and the new price suggested, and I can go ahead and submit this one for an approval. Going to submit this for approval, I can go and just review everything in terms of what is being updated to that particular part. I can assign an approver to it, and then I can go to my approvals inbox, and I can see who this has been assigned to for approval, and that approver can go ahead and review the updates I'm wishing to make, as well as all of the additional updates that our AI agent has already processed. Once this gets approved, this is ultimately going to trigger a write-back to our source ERP system, and the pricing, the part is now going to be reflected with an updated price back in our system. So we're very excited about this, this solution, and really what's next here. We want to be able to scale this out to all of the segment code differences we have across our materials. We want to make sure we're consistently pricing our parts more on a dynamic basis based on market conditions and what our customers are responding to us with. And we want to be able to expand this not only across our mining business division, but also our construction equipment division and other divisions as well that can benefit from the same kind of a solution. So with that, I'd like to thank you all very much for your time today. Specifically, I'd like to thank Justin and Pedro, Pedro's here with me today, on their tremendous leadership from the business on this effort. And also our Palantir team, Jordan and Marshall for sure have been here every step of the way, as well as Brad, who's helped us out a lot. So we really appreciate the partnership with Palantir and excited to keep moving forward. Thank you.